Welcome to the one video that will take you from Excel visuals newbie to seasoned professional. For this, we'll go from having raw data with no visuals to creating an awesome dashboard to impress anyone in 5 steps. Let's go. All right, so here's the scenario. Suppose we're hired as a consultancy to help out this company and try and improve their performance. Now for this, for us as a junior analyst, we simply have to make a dashboard that's gonna show some of the key metrics and visuals to assess how the company has been performing. If we look at the Excel file, some of these metrics are gonna include the project roadmap, so some kind of a timeline, alongside the sales for this company, some of their satisfaction scores, staff turnover, etc. And you can download this Excel file that we'll be working with for free in the video description as well. So step one for us is going to be to create a project timeline. And one of the better visuals for that is going to be a Gantt chart. So let's take a look at the file. We'll go up over here, and this is where we want to create the timeline. And right next to it over here under raw data, we can see all of the data that we'll need. So for this, we'll have the start date for the project alongside the end date for each of the individual tasks. So it might be the client onboarding, gathering the data, developing a solution, and so on. And the duration here is gonna be how long each task is going to be for. So to create a visual for this, first thing, we're just gonna select all of the start dates. So go to Control down arrow. From here, what we're gonna do is go under Insert, and we'll go down over here, and we want a 2D. We wanna get the stacked bar chart, which is the second one over here. So just click on that. And right now we're missing all of the duration, which is gonna be this part to the side. Now to add that, we're just gonna right click here, go to select data. And from here, we wanna add a new series. So let's go to add, and the series name for us, it's gonna be the duration days, and the values here, just click on that. We're just gonna select all of these. So Control Shift down all the way to the bottom there and just hit okay. Then for this horizontal part, these numbers, we actually want them to be the names of the tasks. So we'll go to edit again, Control Shift down, hit okay there, and okay again. And just like that, we have all of these to the side. Now let's work on some of the formatting for this. So firstly, these lines over here, we actually don't want, we only want these orange ones, which actually represent the days for us. So let's go ahead and right click on that under fill. We're just gonna go with no fill there. Great, now we're just gonna have to invert the order of this over here. As you can see, client onboarding should be the top thing, as that's the first thing we would do. So go to right click, format axis, and towards the bottom here, you're gonna find the categories in reverse order. So let's click on that. And just like so, that's looking better. We'll also remove the chart title. And for these dates, what we're gonna do is go to right click, go to format axis, and here let's basically remove this gap and this gap over here to the side as well. So it's the minimum and maximum bounds that we need to change. But you can see that they're here in number format, they're not in date format, which makes it a bit tricky for us. So what we're gonna do instead is just, first we're gonna get out of that. So we're just gonna select the actual dates. So we want the very first date and the very last one. So we're just gonna go equals and select that first start date. And again, equals and select that very last date. Hit enter. We're just gonna change these two. So first we'll select them. We're gonna change them to number format. So Control 1 is a shortcut there. We're gonna go under number and we're okay with that. Hit okay there. And so these are the numbers that we want. So now we can go up here again. And for the minimum bound, we now know that it's gonna be 44805. And for the maximum, it's the 44855. Hit enter there. And now you can see how that range has nicely changed for us. Let's now go ahead and resize this chart over to the dashboard here. So I'm just gonna drag it over. And you basically need to stretch it out. So let me fast forward that. Now we can very clearly see how long each of the tasks is going to take, where developing a solution is probably gonna take the longest. One more thing we can do is add labels. So that's gonna show the actual days. So this is gonna take 20 days, 5 days, etc. Next up, in step two, we want to create a table with a trend line. So if we scroll down over here, you can see the sales by country, where we've got all of the dates alongside each country. And we wanna create a trend line over here. Now to do so, we're gonna go to the Insert tab, And from here, under Sparklines, we'll go to click online. You can see there that the date range pop-up shows up, and we want it to be all of these here. So we'll just select these four. And the location is fine where it says trend, so we'll hit OK there. Now we have that trend, and we can see how it looks. We can even go further and say change the color or actually increase the weight so we can see it a bit better. Let's say I go for 1.5, for example. Then we're just gonna press the shift down arrow and hit Control D. That's gonna drag it down all across these. Also, within that table, we have the growth rates, which maybe we wanna identify a bit better using conditional formatting. So that way we'll find out better when it's negative, maybe we have a red sign or something like that. So go to Control Shift down to select all of them. Then we're just gonna go under conditional formatting up here. We're gonna go for icon sets, and we have quite a big range here. We go with the flags, so just click on those. And now, what doesn't really make sense is that we have a 20% growth rate, which is quite a good growth rate, and yet it's still in yellow. So let's go ahead and change the rules here a bit. So under conditional formatting again, we'll go to manage rules, and then we'll go to edit those rules. So let's take a look here, and as you can see, it's going by percentage, and that's why it looks a bit off there. So we're gonna go by number instead, where, hey, if it's greater than zero, then we should want it in green, because that's a positive thing. Then we want it, when it's zero, we want it to be in yellow. So we're just gonna change that to a number as well. And finally, when it's less than zero, it should be in red, which makes sense to us. So we'll go okay, and we're just gonna go okay again. Now that seems to make more sense. If I artificially change this to a zero, then it should go to yellow like so. Press Ctrl Z to go back there. And if you're liking this Excel video, you can also consider taking our Excel for Business and Finance course, where we teach everything we know about Excel. And what makes this course different is that it's all applied to the real world. While we still cover the theoretical lessons like formatting, formulas, and charts, we also offer case studies that simulate the type of work you might be assigned in your day-to-day, ranging from financial modeling to cleaning a data set and presenting some visual insights. And if you get stuck along the way, you can easily ask us questions in the discussions forum. We also offer several other courses, including PowerPoint, finance and valuation, and more. So if you're interested in checking it out, you can get 20% off up until the 31st of December, 2022. So go to that link in the description below. In step 3, we think it would be useful to find out the satisfaction score for our employees and our customers to see if the company is doing okay. Now for this, it's probably best to measure it with a gauge chart. So let's take a look. So here's where the satisfaction scores will be with the gauge charts. And for this, we have this data over here. So we have the customer satisfaction and the employee satisfaction. So the first thing you'll find are the ranges. So this is basically what's gonna measure what's good or bad. And then next to that, we have that point, which is basically the actual score. And don't worry about these two, we'll get to them later. So first things first, we're gonna select these ranges. So Control Shift down there. And then we're gonna go under Insert. Go to these pie charts here, and towards the bottom, you'll find the donut chart, which is the one that we want. So click on that. Now, I know this doesn't look much like a gauge chart yet, but just bear with me. First, we'll remove the title. Let's also remove the legend below. And from here, we'll click on it. Then we'll go to right click, format data series, and we're just gonna rotate this. So the angle of first slice, we want it to be at 270. Hit enter there, and now you can see that this is looking a bit more like it, where this is the bad area, the okay area, and the good area. Then for the donut hole size, let's go ahead and shrink this. So we'll put it at 55, hit enter there. And then let's also remove the fill of this blue area. So just select that blue one. Then we're gonna go towards the bucket, and under fill, we're gonna go to no fill here. There you go. Then for each of these, we're gonna make them red, yellow, and green, just like a traffic light. So we're gonna select the first one. Let's go ahead under color and make that one red. Then the middle one we'll make yellow. Let's go with this yellow up over here. And then this last one, we'll make it in green. So go under colors again. Let's change it to green like so. All right, now this is starting to look more like it, but we're missing the line that's gonna show us where exactly we stand here. So for this, first, let's move the chart down a bit. So we're just gonna drag it down over here. And from here, we're just gonna right click, go to select data, and we need to add more areas. So hit on add there. And the name is gonna be the point for us. And the values that we wanna add are gonna be these three over here. Then we're just gonna hit okay there and hit okay again. Now, what we wanna do is this whole outside area, we actually wanna change. So we'll go right click, then we're gonna go to change series chart type. And just bear with me, I know this isn't looking too good right now, but we'll get there. And for this bottom area where it says point, we're gonna change that to a regular pie chart. Hit okay there. Great. Now for this gray area, just click on it. Make sure you only have the gray area selected, and we're gonna go with no fill. Same thing goes with this blue area. We're gonna go with no fill. And so that orange area should represent the line. But the problem is that it's all the way down there. And that's because we actually changed the angle of this one. Remember, we changed the angle to 270. So we need to do the same here. So we'll go right click, format data point, and then we're gonna change this over here to 270, hit enter there. Then we're just gonna select the chart more generally, the pie chart there, and go to no border as well, so we can see it better. Same thing with this side, go to no border. Okay, now that's looking a lot more like it. For this orange, we'll change it to something like a black or a dark color like so. And one final thing we can do here is add some labels. So go to right click there and go to add label. Now you can see that it's showing this 2, which represents this number here, and it's not what we want. So we'll double click on it. Up over here under the formula bar, we'll go to equals and select the 60%, hit enter, and control B to bolden if you want. Now that's looking more like it. So now when you change this score to say 55, that's gonna move accordingly. Same thing if I go with 20. And if you're wondering what this second point is, this is actually the thickness. So if I change this to a 10, you'll see how that arrow gets so much thicker. Press Ctrl Z there to go back. Now that we have this gauge chart, let's go ahead and remove the border. So no border. Let me fast forward how I resize it. Awesome. Now that we've done the customer satisfaction score, we just need to do the same thing with the employee side. So we would basically Ctrl C and then paste that graph over here, and just change the ranges by going to right click and then selecting data. But for that, I'm just gonna fast forward it, as you probably already understand the steps. Great, now we have two gauge charts for the customer satisfaction and the employee satisfaction. Now step 4 here is to create a actuals versus budget for our expenses to see how the company's expenditures have been relative to their budget. This chart is gonna be over here towards the bottom where it says budget versus actual. And if we scroll over to the side, we can see all of the data that we'll need, which is this one here. So we have all of the typical expenses alongside the budget and the actual amounts. So we're gonna select all of this. So Control Shift down, Control Shift right there. From here, go to insert. And what we're gonna want under the column charts here is this one, the first one there. Just click on that. And we'll delete the title there because we don't need it. And next up, what we need to do is just select this whole orange area, right click and go to format data series. And we want this as a secondary axis. So you can see one's gonna be on top of the other. As of now, you can't see it too well, but the reason for this is so that the actual amount is gonna be on top of the budget. So we wanna change the gap width here to something like say 400. Hit enter there. Now you can see what that's more or less looking like. Same thing with these outside ones, the blue ones. Let's go ahead and reduce the gap width there to say 159, say. And just like so, that's looking a bit better. Then we'll change the colors here. So the budget ones, let's say that we want these. Actually, let's start with the actuals. We're gonna change the color of these to something like a red because it's an expense. So we'll go with the red there, like so. Then for the blue ones in the back, what we're gonna do is go under format up on top, Then we're just gonna put the outline as the red. But for the shape fill, let's go with something like a light orange, like so. Now that's looking a lot more like it. One final thing here you might notice is that the sides here, the axes, aren't exactly the same. So this one's up to 500, while this one is to 450. So let's correct that. We'll go to right click, we'll go to format axis. Then the maximum here, we want it at 500. Hit enter there, and now that's looking more equal. We can just delete one side because they both say the same thing. And now let me fast forward how I moved it over. Great, now we can clearly see that the marketing team here has actually spent way too much money, so we might need to control that. And finally, in step 5, we want to see the company's headcount and how that's evolved. And a good way to visualize that is using a waterfall chart. So over here towards the side, this is where we'll add the staff turnover. You can see that we've got all of the staff data that we need, which is the previous year's total alongside any new hires, layoffs, and departures. That's gonna reach the 2023 total. So we'll select all of that by going to Control A. Then under Insert, we're gonna go over here towards the side, click on that, and we want the waterfall. So just click on that one. We'll remove the title there. Now you can see that it actually looks a bit odd in that it doesn't actually fall back down. So this last one that we want as a total, we're actually gonna have to right click on it and go to set as total. Now that makes a lot more sense. Where we started with this amount in 2022, these were the changes and it went down to this other amount. For the decreases here, just click on that in the legend. Let's change them to a red color. So under fill, we're gonna change them to red, say. For the increases, let's change them to, say, we're fine with the blue, say, but this one we'll also put as a total. Right click on it, and let's say that we put it in a gray color as well. So under fill, we're gonna go with this gray. Now you can clearly see the trend. Then for the legend, we can also put it down towards the bottom. So under format legend, we're gonna say put it on the bottom there. And we also don't wanna fill. More generally, we don't want a border there, so we're gonna go no border and no fill. Now let me fast forward how I move that. Great, so that's our waterfall chart done, and just like that, we've created an awesome dashboard where we can see the project roadmap using a Gantt chart alongside the table, seeing more or less our historical sales figures, our satisfaction scores with the gauge charts, and these column charts to see our budget versus actuals. And finally, the evolution of our staff across the whole year. Now, sometimes creating these charts is a bit tedious and there are more powerful softwares like Power BI. So let me know in the comments if you want a tutorial on that. For more on Excel, check out this video over here to learn how to make a dashboard, or this link over here to take our Excel course. Hit that like and that subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.